I'll pull up and just bring you back down.
Okay. How are you doing?
Take your time.
All right.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Take this with us in our car.
Do you want to get the door?
What we ought to be about. This
business in positions make money off of trying to divide humanity, person against person, class against class. We're here to celebrate making the dream stay alive.
Special and simple guest to our celebrated, elected, and appointed municipal, county, school, and state officials, fellow comrades in the movement for the equality of all persons. It is my honor of the most remarkable repute to have afforded me this privilege to introduce our stellar and special guest, Mrs. Coretta Scott King. You can find in your encyclopedia and your myriads of who's who, all of her many accounts of her numerous achievements and accomplishments. Therefore, I shall not delve into these, but I will give you this. We all know her as the wife of the most universally renowned martyr of our 20th century, with Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. I present to you at this time a founder, an organizer, a champion in her own rights, the widow of a deliverer, the survivor of a saint, the remaining part of a legacy. I present to you at this time Mrs. Coretta Scott King.
Visit to this area, but certainly I look forward to returning because my husband. second to none. I shall carry back many memories and I'll wish treasure the moments that I have spent with all of you. Thank you. God bless and keep you. I want to thank the Martin Luther King Center Southeast Support Group of Texas for all of the work that you've been doing in promoting the teachings of Martin Luther King Jr. here in this area. I certainly encourage you, and I know you will do, to continue the wonderful work that you are doing, bringing so many people together, bringing about unity in the community. Let me say that we all recently experienced a large gathering of coming together of Black African American males in Washington, which was called the Million Man March on Washington, October 16th. It has generated a national dialogue about the direction of race relations in America. I supported the goals of the march, specifically the pledge to strengthen and heal African American families and promote self-sufficiency in the Black community. Yet I still feel very strongly that there is great virtue and great power in building interracial coalitions for social change. I believe that despite the racism that afflicts our society, there are many people of goodwill of all races who are eager to work in interracial coalitions for social and economic justice. In 1963, my husband, Martin Luther King Jr., outlined a great dream he had for America, a dream of a nation united in justice, equality, and brotherhood. We have made progress toward fulfilling this dream in some respects. Segregation has been replaced by more sophisticated forms of discrimination. Racism and bigotry continue to fester throughout our society. Racial polarization still undermines our hopes for building community in America. A gulf of mistrust and ignorance still keeps us from learning from each other. If we are serious about fulfilling Martin Luther King Jr.'s dream of a nation united in justice and brotherhood and sisterhood, we have to find a way to live together. As Martin said, and I quote, racial understanding is not something that we find, but something that we must create. The ability to work together, to understand each other, will not be found ready-made. It must be created by the fact of contact, he said. If we can build such bridges of knowledge and understanding between people of all races and religions, we will sow the seeds of a new unity in America. Famous African proverb is getting a lot of play these days as the African American community and the whole nation cries out for an antidote to the cancer of violence. The proverb says, it takes a whole village to raise a child. It is a beautiful. Rings true on a broader scale. Not only does the immediate community responsibility for every child who lives within its borders. Our nation has a responsibility to every child because we are all black, white, red, brown, and yellow. Brothers and sisters in the American family.
Self-discipline,
tolerance for diversity, self-respect, and respect for others. Love, forgiveness, compassion, sharing, and most of all, the moral courage to resist peer group pressure and to stand up for what is right.
Deadly weapons and the sky.
to create a decent living for their children. And let us dream of a beloved community where children need look no further than for positive role models than the faces of their own mothers and fathers.